Abhishek Anand, and I work for Acquia. And how many of you know what Acquia is? Alright. So, we at Acquia, we provide application level support and enterprise hosting for Drupal. And our founder is our CTO is Kasisnu, who is also the founder of Drupal. And, I work as a technical architect there. My job is to help the development team with the project technically and to define the workflow and architecture of the whole project. So that's about me. So today what you're going to learn is how we can build a multimedia website like Instagram on Drupal 8. This is an exercise of POC that I did around 6 months back. The purpose of this POC was to find out how ready Drupal 8 is to build a website of that sort. Before that, I would want to know about the audience. I mean, how many of you are aware of what Drupal is? Almost everyone. Drupal. Like, I thought there were a lot of college students here. So, but that's not the case, right? All of us are well versed with Drupal, and how many of you have worked with Drupal 8 already?
Just for checking purpose.
And how many of you have very good knowledge of Drupal 8? Nice. So then I don't think I need an introduction to Drupal 8 and telling you how to install and stuff like that, right? So as you know, like Drupal 8 is not very far from its stable release. We right now have a beta 12 running. I did this when the Drupal 8 was in alpha, so it's like six month old project. So the idea was to do something like Instagram, you know, have pictures. Switch on the light, okay.
Fan.
You enjoy the liberty of switching off the fan in
Bangalore, come to Delhi and just can't deal with it. Right. So the purpose of this exercise was to build something like this. Instagram, where you can get a stream of pictures and videos, and you can apply some filters like you apply on Instagram, different kind of filters on the images, and share it. You can comment on it, you can like it, all these kinds of features. So to build this, we needed a certain set of features. So first we gathered the features. These were the features which were required: a user profile, user connections. Users are able to follow other people. Then upload images and apply different kind of filters. Then uploading videos. Then liking and commenting on a friend's images. One more feature was there is to get a stream of images only shared by your connections. So that was also a tricky part. So these were primarily the features that we wanted to build. Now, if you can take a guess, how many of these features would you get if you install Drupal 8? Just by installing Drupal 8. Any guesses?
Like and comment.
You'll get like and comment? Both? Only comment, I guess, right? Let's see the first feature, user profile. Will you get that? Right? User connection, will you get that? How can we do this? Relationship module? Is it available in Drupal 8? I think flag module can be a good candidate for this, right? But is that available in Drupal 8? In dev version, yes, we have it now. But when I started working on this, it was like 6 months back, we didn't have a stable release of flag module, and we did not have it on D.O. There was a separate development going on GitHub, and I used that flat module for doing it. Uploading images and applying effects? Yes? No? Applying effects? You can do that in Drupal 8. Image field is there, image tag is there, but if you want to apply effects, sepia, aqua, this kind of effects. Right. In Drupal 7, can we do that? Which module? Do you know any module which will help you do that? Can you speak a little louder? Have you seen Instagram or you have your Android phone? Once you click your picture and then you apply some effects, right? Frame, you enhance the image, you give a vintage look, all those things, like you do with Instagram, right? So can you do that in Drupal 7, my question? You'll crop and scale, yes. It's difficult, right? But you can do that very easily with image magic. Right? And there's a module called image cache action in Drupal 7, which will let you do this, right? But again, not available in Drupal 8. Uploading videos, you can do a file upload, but you cannot do a video upload. Like, it will be treated like a normal file. That much is provided by Drupal 8. Commenting, yes. Liking, no. It's not available in Drupal 8. Like feature, to do this, you can do flag module, right? Everyone knows what flag module is? The purpose of flag module is very simple. To flag a content. It integrates very well with views, right? So now when you flag a content, it can be a lot of things. So so flag module can be used for flagging or reporting abuse. If you don't like somebody's comment, you can flag it, report abuse. You can use it for liking, disliking. You can use it for sharing, right? Not sharing. You can use for building connections. You can flag a user. Once you have flagged a user, you can build a connection with them. Like, that means it builds a one-to-one mapping. This model, very simple model, but yet very useful. So now we had a list of features that we wanted to build, and we had known what is going to take us to build this. Some of them are available in Drupal 8, some of them are not. We'll first see what were available, which we have already discussed, and other things which were not available, we'll go in more detail how we did that. Unfortunately, my demo is not working very well because I upgraded my Drupal, it was an alpha version, to beta 12, and a lot of functionality is not working. Otherwise, it would have been great if I could have demoed you the whole product. It was looking good. Unfortunately, that's not happening, but I'll tell you what all things I did. So flag module, we have already discussed. Views. Views is in core already, right? You don't need that. But with views, there are certain problems. While doing this, we added a patch. We contributed something to views. That went as a core commit. Video module, again, was not available in Drupal 8. So again, I started developing video module in Drupal 8 and along with a couple of other people. It's still far from being ready, but the basic framework of video module is ready. Image field crop is a module in Drupal 7, which lets you crop an image as soon as you upload it through the field. Again, this module was not available in Drupal 7. We had to make a contribution again to image field crop. So I started a development of this module, a Drupal 8 version, on GitHub. The plan was to commit it back to Drupal.org, but there's still some work left. Then I created a new module called image field effects, because there was no such module which will basically allow you to build this kind of effects. Right? Well, Image Magic or GD library allows you to have those kind of effects, but not necessarily the feature that we wanted. When you upload, it should open up as a field where you have certain presets already defined. Presets is what you can get from image cache action, but it will not integrate with your field. I'll explain in some time what different things about fields in Drupal 8, but this was required for us to write.
You're talking about modules, when we see that some of the
Yeah. Sorry? It has compatibility issues. Drupal 7 modules, see, modules can't be forward compatible, right? Those modules were written for Drupal 7. The architecture of Drupal 8 has changed a lot. Or for that matter, forget about Drupal 8. If you take a module which is of a specific version, it is compatible with only that version. Because there are a lot of code changes in Drupal which does not make a module which is meant for a previous version compatible with the next version. Right?
So,
all the modules, yeah. That's where developers like yourself and others can come into picture and help port these modules to a newer version. It does not take too much of effort to, like it does, but like not, it's not in rocket science to get a module from D7 to D8. Easily you can spend like a weekend and get it done if it's a small module. If it's a module like views or something, you'll have to probably spend months. But that happens every time. Drupal almost gets a new version in another 4 to 5 years. Like Drupal 7 was released on 7th Jan 2011, right? Drupal 8 will release at around the same time, January, I guess, in 2016. So it takes 5 years. So when Drupal 8 will release, or even before that, all the modules which are available on D.O will be converted by their maintainers to Drupal 8. They will have a Drupal 8 supported version. Mm-hmm. Data stored by a module is lost. For? Okay. Well, one way to prevent that is obviously you take a backup. For example, if something went wrong and data is lost and you want to do something about it, what you can do is you can backup your database. And if your data is lost, there's a module called migrate, right? And Drupal 8 supports most of the migration things in core. Like migrate is supported is in core now. So if your data is really lost, what you can do is you have upgraded your module, like from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8. If you have, say you have upgraded your site from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8, and you see a lot of data losses, you can start migrating your data again. Again, it's my personal recommendation. What I recommend is, rather than trying to upgrade your website from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8 directly, the ideal way is rebuild it in Drupal 8. Right? Get all the modules. Get it.
Yes. Again, use migrate module, write a migration class, and get all your data. That is one way to do it. Other way to do it is to find out why it is not working. Just debug it, you find a problem. Just form module, fix that problem, submit a patch, and the maintainer will bring it to the module. Right?
So, we started writing video module. It was very easy, and at the same time, it was very difficult. Video module is a huge module. It supports a lot of stuff. We wanted just a basic video module. So what we wanted to do was, there is already a file field in Drupal 8. And you know, Drupal 8 is very much object oriented. And all these fields and all this stuff goes as a plugin in Drupal 8. How many of you are aware of plugin systems in Drupal 8? All right, not many people. So basically, idea of plugins in Drupal 8 is to make these kind of features reusable. You define a plugin which works like an interface in common object-oriented paradigm. It is basically a set of classes which defines your plugin and you can reuse it anywhere. So this is a major change from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8. In Drupal 7, you need to write a hook field info and stuff like that. Here, you need to define a plugin. It works on annotation. So you will see that what you write in your comment, your annotation will become your field please name enough. I'll go into the code and show you how a plugin of a video module looks like. So we had to take the file field, the field and the basic plugin. Plugin has two different stuff. One is called formatter, widget format, field widget and field formatter. And then there's a field info. Field info basically defines what the field is. And then we have a formatter and widget. Does anyone know what is a formatter, and field widget? So, I'll tell you what a field formatter is and a field widget is. When you have a field, you want to define how it looks like when you are adding some, inputting some data in it, right? For example, if you have a video field, for example, image field, you want that image field to have a crop on it or an effect on it or something on it, right? Which will help you resize your image or do certain things with that image before you can actually save the data. So you define a formatter. What kind of formatter should I get which will basically let me manipulate something with my input when I'm allowed to input or when I'm presented with the input form of that field. Now once I've inputted the data, that data has to be shown somewhere, right? So I'm sorry, I just confused you guys a little bit. Widget is what helps you in manipulating the input. Formatter is what shows the output, right? So basically what happens is the widget field, for example, if I'm defining an image field widget, what it will do is I'm uploading the image and at that point of time, it lets me crop the image. So that becomes the image field widget. Now when I am displaying that, it becomes a formatter which basically shows the image in a certain format. In the formatter, for example, what I can do is, have you seen a lot of, you must have seen a lot of e-commerce site, right? On an e-commerce site, when you have an image and you hover on the top of it, it shows the enlarged version of the image, right? So it's not a very simple image field. It is an image with something in the background which pops out as soon as you hover on the image. So you can define that as a formatter of image. Drupal 8 lets you do that very easily. So basically you have a field info where you define all the basic storage and stuff like that of the field. Then you have a formatter and then you have a widget. These are the three classes that you will need to define in your plugin to get your, so not classes, interfaces that you need to define in your plugin to get a field working. Now we already had a file field, so we can reuse the file field, extend it, add something on the top of it to get the functionality that we want. What exactly is the functionality that we want is, there should be a file. Once I upload the file, it should not show me the name of the file, it should show me a thumbnail of the file, right? Thumbnail, size and other information, which can go in the field widget. The formatter of a file is generally, you give a downloadable link of the file, right? But here what do we want? We want the formatter to present a HTML5 player or a flash player for that matter, where the user can see a playable video. So we needed to do this much of work, right? After this, we could have done encoding, conversion and stuff like that, which is the very advanced stuff. But we started to do with this. So let me show you the basic module that we built, which is something like this. So we defined a video module. Is it very clear? No, not very clear to everyone. Aha, it will not show. not really sure how to. Is it visible to everyone? No, right? But you will not be able to see the structure. I want to show the structure of this module. Let me try something. Sorry, I can't follow you. Can you say that again? Yeah. I just want to. The presentation doesn't present me the sidebar. That is the problem. That's a good idea. But I think my presentation should have. Okay, so the video model.
The video.module file, which is empty right now. I'll show you what this file contains. And then we have SRC folder, which has basically the plugin. Then we have field formatter, field type, and field widget. So field widget is again what will help me upload the video. The video item.php basically defines the basic data structure of the video, and then video formatter and formatter base. Formatter base is again interfacing the file field and creating a base for video, and then I'm extending it with video formatter so that others can use the same formatter to define different kind of images for video. So this is basically the file structure that I had to build to present this. And then we have a video formatter.html because I want to have a template for how my video should look, which can be changed or manipulated, and it's a good thing for the themers. And then we had some basic CSS file. So now I'll basically show you the content of this file, and this file, so that you can get a basic idea of how fields can, a new field can be defined.
So let's look at video item.php. Now I would enter the presentation mode. So this file, basically in Drupal 8, what you do is you define what the namespace of the file is. I wanted to use certain already available field interfaces, which was basically file field, and then field storage was defined. Form state was required, that's why I had to use it, and screen wrapper was required. The basic thing that we are using as an interface is basically the file item. And then I define the field, like I said, plugins uses meta tag very, very much. So whatever you define here, ID equals to video, label equals to video, will become the title and the ID which you define Drupal 7 for a particular field. And then I define the basic data structure of this. Right. Then I'm basically, what I'm doing is extending the settings so that if I want to add more settings for the video, I can add here. For example, I want to have a restriction on the file type that can be uploaded. So I restricted it only for MP4, WEM, and OOG. And then there was a schema. Schema was required to be defined. So again, all these things are already present in file, in the files. File item. What I need to do is I need to only add different things that I want to add. Right? For example, description, and then the foreign key constraint and all. Whatever I needed to define, I defined it here. Then we had the property definition. There was nothing required. So I added this function. This can you can also remove, because essentially what it is doing is nothing. It's just having this returning the one which is from the parent. And then the storage settings form. Storage settings form is doing nothing, but it is defining whether the file should be public or private and stuff like that. All we needed to do this, and a new field type called video was created for us. And then we had video widget. The video widget will basically define the widget that comes when you are trying to upload a video. Getting the thumbnail was little tricky. It is required a lot of code which is not written yet, but basically we extended the video widget, and there was another validator which was added, which will only validate whether it was the correct extension or not. And then we added a CSS here to style the video widget properly. We needed to add a CSS, and the validation which was required was added here. You can again, here itself you can define, you can, in this widget you can define a JavaScript which will kick in and it will generate the thumbnail. You can write the logic. That logic was there, but I had reverted the code because of upgrading Drupal core. So that code is presently not there, I would have shown it. So basically you define here itself what happens when the video, once you submit the video gets uploaded, and you get a, for transcoding you get stuff where you can transcode it and stuff like that. And then how do I quickly, the formatter was also pretty simple. This did not require anything. It just required an abstract formatter which extends the file base, and then the file formatter we just required to write few lines of code to get the basic functionality working, which was this is just for displaying. We have the formatter, and we define the theme which we require. And the theme is basically the twig file which will render the HTML5 video markup. So that is what was required here, because we just do not want to show a simple file. Now we want to show an HTML markup. So let's see if my video works. I'll try to show you a demo, although I'm pretty sure it is pretty broken right now. I just want to go to the browser. Sorry. Not this one. For Drupal to know that you are defining a new image effect, what it should see is image toolkit operation. There we defined a field, here we defined an image toolkit operation. This tells Drupal to register a new operation called gd colorize. The toolkit that I want to use is gd, operation is colorize, and then what I am doing here is extending gd image toolkit operation base. Right? What it is doing, what I am doing next is, I am adding the RGB value for this operation. What I am doing is, I am enhancing the red, blue and green color of an image. To do that, again I am validating the argument which is supplied by the user for these values. If I want to define a new, say I am defining a new preset called colorize in image field, what it will do is, we will take an image, add a layer of colors on it, right? It will enhance the color. So you will be presented by a field which will say add the value of RGB which you want to enhance this. It is just validating it, right? If the value is greater than 255 or 0, I am simply telling that invalid value is supplied. Once I know the value is supplied is correct, what I am doing is I am just executing it. What it will do is, it will look at an image filter function of image magic, and it will apply the value that I have entered into that, right? So and this is the operation that PHP supports, image filter colorize, and I am giving the arguments red, blue and green here. So this is how you define a new image preset
in Drupal 8. This is another type of plugin. There's one more type of plugin that we defined, which I'll show you right now. ImageEffects. So basically, this is what we defined here is basically a new preset which can be used anywhere else also. While displaying another image, you can make it colorize also. In a view also you can use. It is basically an image effect preset. Now I am defining another effect which is basically using it. Right. Colorize is an operation. An effect can comprise of multiple operations. Right. Like another operation is crop. I want to do colorize and crop together. So I am just defining different kind of effects. The aqua effect, what it will do is, it will give red as 50, blue as 100 and green as 0. So now you get an aqua kind of, aqua means bluer shade of image. Similarly, I have defined a new sepia effect, which will basically add more red and blue and remove the green. So these are the two image effects that were created by the GD operation that we created, which was colorize, right? Other operations could be crop, rotate. These all operations are already available in Drupal core. Colorize was not available, so I had to define that. Why we were doing this? Because we wanted to have that effects. Now, we have defined a GD operation. We have defined an effect, but how do we bring it into the field? Just defining these two will not bring it in the field, right? We have defined how it can be done. How can we colorize an image? But now this colorized image needs to appear in my field, right? When I upload it, the widget needs to have an interface where it can colorize the images, right? So for that, we created a new module called image field effects, which has all the effects. And in the image field crop module, what we did was we added another plugin. One was crop and the other was effects. So this would basically help us to crop the images and add the effects, right? It is similar to what we did for video. We created another field widget which will have all these operations inside it, right? We also did another. This was all done server side. Sometimes you do not want your field to have so much of load on the server, because every time you are doing this, your GD comes into picture and GD library does some processing of images. That's a lot of load. Why do we really need to have so much of load, right? What we can do is, there's a library called camin.js. Camin.js is a server side client side library, which will do the same kind of stuff on client side, which means JavaScript will do all these things. So server does not need to do all these operations. All the browser itself can colorize the images and crop the images. So the idea there was, we just define the colors, save the colors in the database. While we are rendering, the formatter will use the same colors and apply it on the image. So everything is done client side. You don't have to process everything on the server side. So camin.js is another very good library, which you can, I'll show you the homepage of camin.js. So there are examples also. So this is basically the client side library, which will do the same thing. This is an image, I want to apply vintage effect to it. I got the vintage effect. I want to increase the clarity, I want to change the color, it is still rendering. So you can change the image client side only. So this was again something which was done as a plugin only, right? All these contributions are on the GitHub. My GitHub page is github.com/flytoabhishek. You can find all these projects there if you want to play around with it, or you want to help me extend this or complete all these projects. You can fork my repo, do your contribution and submit it back to my, raise a pull request and I'll add it to the code. Sorry? Huh? properly.